Good morning, class.
Good morning, Madam Hooch.
Welcome to your first flying class. Everyone, stick your right hand next to the broom and say up. Come on now.
Up, 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 up.
Try harder with feeling.
Up, 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 up.
Now, mount your broom, grip it tight. When I say go, you will kick off the ground. Keep your broom steady. Hover for a minute and touch back down. 3, 2, 1, go!
Ah! Oh no! No! No!
Mr. Longbottom, come back down this instant!
Harry, we need to help Neville! But I don't know how to fly.
I've only read about it in Quidditch Through the Ages. Do you know how to fly, Ron?
Nope, not a clue.
But I've seen my brothers playing Quidditch before.
Harry, how much do you weigh?
Why do you ask, Hermione?
If a person weighs less, maybe they can fly faster? We need someone who is fast to get to Neville.
You have a good point, Hermione. But previous flying experience or broom skills is important too.
I think we need to account for both student weight and broom skills. In that case, we can use multiple regression to predict flying speed. Remember we talked about linear regression in the chocolate frog episode? Multiple regression is an extension of linear regression that looks at the relationship between two or more predictor variables. So, the two predictor variables are student weight and broom skills. And the response or dependent variable is flying speed.
That's right. Madam Hooch, I think you have the records for each student. Can we use it to run a multiple regression model?
Of course you can. Here's the data set. We have four columns: broom type, student weight, broom skills, and flying speed.
I have a clean sweep one. It's not that great.
Thanks, Madam Hooch. Let's use the LM function to build a multiple regression model. And, as in the Chocolate Frog episode, we can use the SUM function from the J2S package to generate a clean summary of the results.
Give it a go, Harry!
Here's the results table. Let's take a look at the estimates for the independent variables. We have negative 0.2 for student weight and 0.18 for broom skills. What do they mean, Hermione?
It means that for every 1 pound increase in student's weight, there is an associated 0.2 decrease in speed, which is in kilometers per hour. So, on the other hand, for every 1 point increase in broom skills, there is an associated 0.18 increase in speed.
That's right.
It looks like your hypothesis is valid, Harry, and the p-values for both cases are almost zero. This means that both student weight and broom skills are likely to influence flying speed.
We must also not forget to check if the model meets the assumptions of multiple regression.
Yes, we will talk about the assumptions in detail in another episode, but there are four main assumptions for multiple regression. The first assumption is linearity of the data. And the second is homogeneity of variance, or homoscedasticity, like we discussed previously in the Chocolate Frogs episode. And the third assumption is that the residuals should be normally distributed. The final assumption is there should be no multicollinearity between predictors. Multicollinearity isn't a problem with one predictor variable, but in this case, we have two predictor variables. So, we need to check if there is high intercorrelations among these two variables. We can use the variance inflation factor score to assess multicollinearity. Let's run the WIF function from the CAR package. The variance inflation factor for student weight and broom skills is around 1. A variance inflation factor of below 5 means that collinearity is not an issue, so our model is okay. How do we visualize multiple regression models since we have two predictor variables and one outcome variable? So we need 3 axes in total. We can generate a 3D graph using the Plotly package. We can specify the outcome variable flying speed as the Z-axis, student weight as the x-axis, and broom skills as the y-axis.
Very cool, Hermione. Here's an interactive 3D plot I made. We can move it around and hover over the data points to show each data value.
I like it very much, Harry. I wonder if we can also generate a 2D plot.
Yes, we can.
The Giraffe Extra package has the ggpredict function to visualize predictions from multiple regression models. We can also make an interactive 2D plot using ggpredict. Check it out, Hermione.
Wow, blue's my favorite color. This interactive plot is great when there's a lot of data points. We can hover over the points to see the individual values.
Hey guys, Neville really needs our help. He's in trouble.
I'll go, Ron.
Harry, no way. Madam Hooch said we'd be expelled. Besides, we don't even know how to fly.
I'll be fine, Hermione.
Give me a hand, Neville. Harry! Harry! I can't reach you.
Got you.
Harry Potter, follow me. You're in big trouble, young man.